I've heard once, invoke the ancestors, give thanks for the ancestors. I just don't stop and allow those permission to speak and I just give thanks. I am Mariella, I'm Mary Jones. You feel free to call me Mariella, you can call me Mary, you will answer to both. I give an answer to Empress, Queen, Sister, give thanks. I am a member of Team Soul. And just to let you know what Caritalents is, about a year ago, the University of the West Indies and the University of Florence and the government of Italy decided to sponsor a program in the region, in Barbados and Dominica, where we looked at training persons to go into communities to train other persons, mostly young people, about heritage and culture. So the course was a pretty nice course. We had a number of persons, a number of professionals come in and conducted some sessions with us. And some of those persons, we looked at music, we looked at traditional music, we looked at African spirituality. During that time, we had to, it was about roughly 6 months of teaching and another 2 months of actually working with the community. So when we heard that we had to work with persons who, we had to work with a group of young people, and basically they want us to work with underprivileged young people. And while my colleagues were scratching their heads wondering, where can we get young people from? I knew immediately who I wanted to work with. And when I put it out to my colleagues, before the group, when I put it out, they actually agreed. Sorry, probably I should have done this first. Let me introduce some members of my team. When I call your name, if you can please stand. We have my sister, my very, very dear sister, in every sense. Probably not my blood sister, but she's my sister. I love her just as much. The lovely Lisetta Sharani. We also had an artist and a teacher, Gail Faulkner Steele. We had another professional photographer, Risa Shapton, who's not here today. And then we also had a brother who I love, who I absolutely adore. A brother who I call the walking encyclopedia. He's better than what I said here, right? Dr. Anthony Richards. And with this program, we were guided by another person who I really, really adore. You know, just now I was telling Sharani, just look at him. He looks so majestic, you know, and I love this brother. And this brother is Ashanti Trotman. And we had a number of Italian lecturers come to us as well and spoke to us and lectured us in different areas. One person who's still here with us today is Dr. Michele Morellini. Italian. We call him Moby for short. And he will have given us a lot of guidance through this last stage of our program. Let me not talk too much because I really know what I'm going with. At times I could go on and on and on and on. But we had a few weeks where we worked with the young persons. And during that session, we also brought in some specialists, some of our specialists, some of our community specialists to really help us out. And one of those is an elder who I have a lot of love for. Elder Baba John, so if you have to just show Baba John. Baba John actually guided us through one of our sessions and shared a lot of knowledge with us and allowed us to visit his home and we humbly give thanks. Thanks, Baba John. Yes, we worked with young people, and I mean these young people, I think we taught them, and I think we learned a thing or two as well, you know. We worked with Ramon, Tanika, Tremaine, Javon, Erica, Jamun, my sister dear, I can't remember her name, please forgive me, Selena, and I think it's, you will see a few photos, and some of them were shot earlier, Aaliyah. Some of, pardon? Right, Aaliyah. So we work with them, and we will have gone into Bridgetown, and outside of Bridgetown as well, and it was very emotional. When I say very emotional, we visited some sites that brought out a lot of emotions. We visit some sacred sites. We visit sites where our ancestors are. We visited sites where we think that our ancestors were not given due regard, you know, they're just there. And that had a huge impact on people. And like Adrian said, you know, he called on the ancestors. You have to give thanks to the ancestors because we are because they were, you know. For me personally, I feel like if I stand on the shoulders of my ancestors, when I'm going through certain tribulations and trials, you know, or if I know I'm going through, about to enter into a certain situation, I call on my ancestors, I'm like, yeah, you know, I need God to really walk with me. So that's how I really view my ancestors. And they will have produced some items. When you're finished, you can look around and see some of the items which they produced. We looked at ancient and modern secret meanings of everyday things. We looked at forgotten Bajan ceremonies, which really and truly, they're our African stories, they're our African history, they're our African heritage. Things that, similar things that we didn't even know, you know what? This is what was done in the motherland. We looked at plants and herbs. We looked at hidden meanings in traditional songs. So we visited sites seeking legend and sacredness, you know, and throughout that, these young people this evening will have something to say or show of all that. So at this stage, I'd like to invite Paul. His name is Roman Paul, and I mean, when I see him, he has